Hey guys, hey, actually a coach in my VIP 1 and VIP 2. She does a bit of one-on-one as well. And she is with her incredible baby, her baby Harley.
And now my cast decided to join in as well.
Oh my God. Everyone wants YouTube attention, right? Everyone wants YouTube attention. So I am in quarantine with Sandas. And Sandas has been really nice and she like accepted me. So now we live together for the next, until coronavirus is over and all the pets. So today we're gonna talk about how to be high value during coronavirus and how to stay a challenge as well. So I left my phone somewhere else, but it's fine. So we, as we coach girls, so many girls go like, oh, what should I do? You know, should I see him? Like, it's coronavirus. Or guys start texting like really sweet messages. You know, like we get all romantic with coronavirus. And where did I leave my phone? Oh, I left it upstairs. It's fine. But yeah,
it happens. Just gonna have to wing it, love.
Yeah, I'll just have to. Yeah, basically, I've been receiving myself a lot of kind of romantic coronavirus messages, which actually sound quite a lot of booty calls, because it's actually really easy for men now. Yeah. If you're dumb, if you're being dumb, it's very easy for them. If you're being smart, you actually can be a challenge, and you can even benefit from a coronavirus in a way. Yeah,
they're basically saying, put on a mask and come to my house because we can't go out.
Yeah.
So come to my house. And girls are like, oh yeah, but it's corona, so maybe I should just go over to his house. And it's like, no.
No, you don't go. Like, you know, your health comes first. However, the kind of dumb, naive girls who like, oh my God, it's so romantic. You know, I'm going to show up there. And he's like, come to my house. Where is food? Where is toilet paper? You know. And, you know, like a lot of girls do that. However, ladies, if you do not go to their house, you are actually being a challenge. It's a little bit like a long distance relationship. Mm-hmm. You know why a lot of long distance relationship work with especially guys who are alpha men, because during long distance relationship, you are actually naturally a challenge because you have obstacles in between. So he needs to conquer to get to you. You can't just see each other at like any time that you want to see each other. So during coronavirus, same thing, you know, you can be a challenge. And you can be high value.
Absolutely.
And, you know, let him charm you, let him pursue you, let him arrange the FaceTime and so on, you know. And how to be a challenge during coronavirus, because a lot of girls say like, well, Greta, you know, like I'm sitting at home, I'm doing nothing, you know, be like, how am I supposed to be a challenge during coronavirus? So I'll let Sandas answer that.
Oh God, okay. Well, first of all, I do want to definitely say that if he likes you enough, he will wait to meet up with you. I know a lot of you girls are getting asked out on first dates with guys who are saying, oh, you know, we can't go out, so let's just come over to my house. So it's like the perfect opportunity for them to kind of capitalize on something that is not, you know, it's a pandemic and it's quite worrying. But and some girls who are like, oh, finally he's asked me out, I'm, you know, I really want to see him, so I might, can I go over to his house, like asking for grit and my permission. And it's like, no girl, you still don't go over.
You stay like, home safe, like, yeah. Why would you kill yourself?
Exactly.
Or like, you know, for a guy, he needs to be killing himself.
Exactly.
For you, he needs to be serenading at your house. Now it's like in Italy, if you look at Italy, everyone's serenading. This is the time when we have to be creative, because we can't have you easily. So
absolutely.
Let them be creative. Let them think how to get to you. Don't just jump into a taxi and,
Go over to his house because you really desperately. I said to Greta before, and Greta, everybody knows, who knows me, knows I like Leonardo DiCaprio. I'm like, even if he was like, babe, do you want to come over and chill? I'd be like, no, Leonardo, I'm sorry. I'm a good girl. I'm staying at home, protecting myself, protecting the people around me, obeying the law. If you want to see me, boo, you're going to have to wait. Exactly. So even if it's him, even if it's the man of your dreams, you make him wait. And if he wants you enough, he will wait. And when he finally sees you, he's going to be like, oh my God. It's going to be, you know, like the face mask off, running on the beach towards each other. It's going to be beautiful.
Also, so how to be a challenge during coronavirus. So many girls say like, but I'm sitting home doing nothing. Well, I am at Sanda's house because she kind of accepted me and gave me a helping hand. I was really stuck. And so I'm very grateful.
Bless you.
what do we do? We're working every single day while being locked up in here.
Exactly.
You know, we actually being locked up in a place and we are thinking of the ways how to create a business, how to be busy.
Mm-hmm.
We watching, you know, lots of self-love, lots of personal development. Literally, this is what it involves, our evenings involve. Someone snoring?
It's my dog. She has like a thing. Good. One girl just went, you do not say no to Leonardo. Love, when it's quarantine, you say no to Leonardo. Even Leonardo. Absolutely.
You say no to whoever, everyone. Mr. President as well.
Exactly. Especially him. Sorry, go on. Yeah.
Okay, especially him. So girls, be busy, read, create a business. Like, there's so many things that you can do at home and be busy. Same as you're busy when you go to work. Now it's your time. It's like a holiday. You know, it's like you have to be in jail or something. You know, you lock yourself up. So think of how you can either monetize it or improve yourself. You know, there's a million things that you can do at home. Just don't be texting guy all the time looking totally bored, because that's going to be the first turn off, like, as you're being an open book.
Absolutely.
You know, and let him still text you and chase and serenade for you, and in no way say yes to booty calls over corona. Like, guys are still asking out for like coffee dates and stuff.
Yeah, it's like, it's so ridiculous. Please. Are you crazy?
It's like, I feel quite insulted when I get messages like that. I'm like, you want me to risk my life to go on a coffee date with you? Like, you like fell off the tree or something? You know, like, I wouldn't step it into helicopter right now, you
know.
It's like, no, please respect, you know,
pick up that hobby that you said you've wanted to do for so long. We all have things that we've been putting off because we don't have time. Now you have all the time in the world. Do what you said that you were gonna do and you didn't get to do. Like, even I was talking to Greta the other day that I wanted to, but always, I'm a big PlayStation gamer, so I'm like, you can't tell by looking at me, but I love playing PlayStation. And I was like, you know what, Greta, I've been putting it off for ages. I want to start my own YouTube channel just playing PlayStation games on it. She's like, girl, what's holding you back?
I'm here with her. I'm like, I'll tell you everything about YouTube. You know, like, monetize me. Absolutely. Same as I'm monetizing her right now. I'm like, you're coming on
So exactly. So I'm now going to start that. Whereas before, I'd put that on hold because I'm like, I've got other things to do with the property. And now, because I can't go and see anything, I can't go out to the property, I can't do anything outside.
Yeah,
I'm like, okay, you know what? We're stuck in the house. Let's take advantage. I'm going to be playing more PlayStation. We might as well be filming it. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, do that thing that you've been putting off and start going after that dream that you wanted to do that you said you didn't have time for. Absolutely.
Yeah. And keep being a challenge. You still don't need to reply to him every single second. You don't need to be like, oh, I'm bored. What are you doing? What you up to? How you are you bored?
Exactly.
How
no. Are you bored? Why are you bored?
Because you're a loser.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
Why you're bored. Losers are never. Losers are never bored. Non-losers are never bored.
Exactly. People have stuff to do.
Yeah. Okay. So we're gonna answer some questions, ladies.
Oh yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So Sarah says, Sanda's Greta. In your opinion, why are couples arguing so much in this time? Especially when we are both working from home.
That's a great question. That's a very good question.
Which one do you... Especially if we both working from home.
Yeah, I think it's because they're in each other's faces so much.
Yeah.
They're in each other, we had this question yesterday. Like, literally, they're in each other's faces so much. And even then, it's like... I remember one of our ladies in our VIP one groups, she asked, so I'm going to be working from home. My boyfriend is going to be wanting to be in my face all the time. What do I do? I said, even if he's complaining to you that you're not sitting with me, you're not, I want you to stay with me all the time. You have to just get your book, get your work, go and sit in your separate room and still have your own time.
Challenge.
Find
That's
your
how
time.
You stay a challenge. So many of you ladies, you ask, how do I stay a challenge if I'm married or, you know, or we live together? This is how you stay a challenge. You don't need to be like going, oh, that actually makes me smile so much, because so many dating coaches coach women saying like, oh, you need to be going out, you need to see all your girlfriends, you need to be busy so he can't reach you, right? This is how you stay a challenge, this is how you're high value, this is how he wants you. If you follow those dating coaches' advice, what are you supposed to do now?
Yeah.
Right?
When you're stuck in the house.
When you're stuck in the house. So at the end of the day, it's not about you going out. And a lot of times when we go out drinking, seeing our friends, gossiping, we are actually not being high value. We are wasting our life. We
Absolutely.
Are wasting our time when we could be focusing on our goals and dreams and building empires for ourselves. Because ladies, if you want to be happy in life, it's not the guy who will make you happy. It's you who will make you happy.
Absolutely.
God didn't create you just for the sake of being married and like
having
babies and like having that guy, that husband that you're like, oh my God, you know, it created you so you can experience life, so you can leave something behind it, so you can create a meaning. You know, again, when you're gonna die and he's gonna say, what have you done with the life that I gave you? And you're like, oh, I got married.
And
you
I
know?
Had a baby, which is great, but people have been doing that for centuries. Like, be like, you know, I always say, be like the Malcolm X's of the world, be like the Mother Teresa's of the world, be
you
somebody
can make
who
a
leaves
difference.
A mark.
You
yeah.
can make a difference.
So when you go, it's not like, oh, my biggest achievement. I'm not saying it's not an achievement before
it's
everybody
amazing.
Jumps on me,
yeah,
but do something that, you know, people are going to remember your name because you were the one who, I don't know, cured cancer, cured the coronavirus.
Oh my God. Yeah.
You were
yeah.
the one who kind of led a
Leave
country.
Legacy. Yeah.
And, you know, created stability in the region, or, you know, even small things like helping your neighbor if they're elderly, if they're struggling, or even donating your time to charity. Like, I was watching yesterday a lady who's saying she wants to plant 1 million trees in the world to combat climate change. That's amazing. You know,
yeah,
something
yeah.
like that.
Make a difference. Be passionate
exactly.
about making a difference. And when you're passionate about making a difference, this is when he will start to admire you. This is when you will get the respect. This is when he will start to chase you and fit in around your life. Because he will be like, what are you doing? He'll be like, I'm planting trees. He'll be, can I see you? No, sorry, I'm planting trees. Oh, is tree more important than me? Yes, it is. You know, like, and when you'll start, you'll have no choice but to fit around you.
Absolutely.
Because you will be not making him important, but making your goals and, you know, your own life important. This is how queens, this is
Absolutely.
How you become a queen. This is how you are a queen.
Absolutely.
So focus on your goals. And going back to couples arguing, just shift your focus from him. Shift your focus. Don't be in his face. Yeah, I can see.
Yeah. Getting some great questions, ladies.
Yeah. Everyone tells me that having a child is the most important thing in the world when you are a woman. It's so annoying for me.
Yep.
You know, I was kind of raised in a different way.
I wasn't.
I wasn't. Well, this is why we're doing the live together.
I exactly feel exactly where you're coming from.
Yeah, I was never ever pushed into, I actually never heard from my dad pushing me towards marriage at all. If anything, he thought I'm the luckiest girl on earth being single, and he even now tells me, Greta, you're so lucky, I wish I was in your shoes. So, and when I was little, actually, because, you know, my mom was kind of, like, my mom was high value, but she didn't know the stuff, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, I would look at her and I would be like, oh my God, like, why would I ever want to grow up to bloody wash his socks and
yeah,
cook him
exactly.
food? You know, like I didn't have this urge that I want to get
no.
married for what, you know? So this is how I kind of grew up. But obviously, you don't, like, if you're high value and you're doing things correctly, you're not going to be in a place where my mom was. And my mom now, she is like, she has the mindset, so she's doing good. But yeah, like, I never was kind of, any, like everybody else were kind of like pushing me towards it, except for my parents, which was actually so nice. You know? So whereas for you, it was a bit different.
It was. I think when you, it depends, like for my culture, well, we're not very cultural, but you, like parents, family are influenced by people around them who are very cultural. And I think especially in like Middle Eastern and Asian cultures, there's a big emphasis on you could be the, you know, a rocket scientist, you could be the first lady in Mars for all they care, but if you don't have a husband and you don't have a child, you don't have anything, you've not achieved anything, and you have to have children by a certain age, even if those kids have done nothing with their life, even if that husband beats you, or even if he like treats you like crap, as long as you've got one, you've achieved something. So yeah. I completely get exactly where you're coming from, but you have to be the one who changes. You have to be the one who pioneers the change.
You have to be very strong, girls.
Exactly.
You have to be very strong, wise, and logical. And so many times you're pushed into a marriage when the guy is wrong for you, you know, just for the sake of being married. But, you know, if you can say no, do say no.
Absolutely.
You know, and keep improving yourself and keep believing. You know, me and Sunda's been talking about God quite a lot because, you know, we both believe in it. And you just have to believe, guys, when you ask for what you want, when you improve yourself, this is when you get what you want. You know, because in life you will get not what you deserve, but what you think you deserve. So having a belief is really important. And yeah. Okay, so let's see more questions. We're gonna do lots of questions, girls. So ask your questions. We are here too, all for you to entertain you. How do you deal with being jealous of other girls around him and feeling like the other girls are better than you?
Oh, I never thought like that. Other girls are better than you? Who is this other girl? I don't think she's been born yet or she ever will be. No.
Love yourself. Be strong in here. When you know who you are, when you have your own value and worth, you're not threatened by the other girls.
Confidence.
Yes, confidence. And actually, if you're threatened by the other girls and you're sharing this, I would actually be so worried to be your friend.
Mm-hmm.
Because I would be like, oh my God, she's jealous of me.
I can't share anything with
her. Can't share anything. She's going to be jealous.
Yeah.
I see the jealousy. She's so insecure.
Yep.
I don't want to be friends with her because like she's going to be talking behind my back because she's so insecure. You see, ladies? So don't be that insecure girl. Be a strong girl who sees another beautiful girl and is lifting her up.
Yeah, absolutely.
And doesn't feel threatened by her.
Absolutely.
You know, support each other. Encourage each other. You know, a guy, if a guy really, really loves you, you encouraging the other woman, he will see you as, you know, as strong, as a woman who really believes in herself, who's very, very secure, mature, mm-hmm. and confident. And don't give attention to other girls. Like, you know, if you're insecure and you're in a place where either he's trying to make you jealous or you've seen a girl who is prettier and you're still feeling insecure, you know, like, just don't give any attention to it. At least fake it until you make it. Until you become high value, fake it. Like, ignore these girls. You know, like, ignore them. But in the meantime, fill yourself up by working on yourself, like, by loving yourself, by creating value for yourself, by, you know, being valuable, by respecting yourself. When you will fulfill yourself with self-love, you're not going to be insecure and jealous of the other girls.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And men love confident women.
Oh my God, we love confident women.
They love it. Like, it's like they're kryptonite.
Who doesn't? Why would you want to be with insecure one? Ladies, so many of you come and you say like, oh, my boyfriend is a narcissist, right? And then we talk about your behavior and it turns out that you're the narcissist. It's true, right?
Yeah.
Because we're actually acting like needy, insecure, texting
absolutely.
All the time.
Give me attention.
Yeah.
I need to, if you don't
blaming,
give me attention, I don't
complaining.
Feel good.
If you're blaming, complaining, calling, texting, who is the narcissist in the relationship?
And you're getting your self-worth from a man. Like, if he doesn't think you're pretty enough or good enough, all of your confidence is gonna drop. And it's like you should never put that much power in someone else's hands. Power should be in your hands all the time.
Yes.
To feel like I'm good enough, I'm worthy enough. Even if nobody likes me, I'm still a queen. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's, those women are the ones who lead nations.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? They don't care about, oh, this person's opinion. Oh, you have an opinion? Okay, thank you. I don't care. Do you know what I mean? You kind of, you have your happiness in your own pocket. Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. And Sanda just reminded me by sharing this, she reminded me one of my client's stories. I'm going to kind of rephrase it because, you know, she told me, Greta, just please don't share it. So I will rephrase that. But basically what happened, she found her boyfriend cheating on her. And instead of kind of going like, oh my God, I am done. I'm never speaking to you again. You don't deserve me to basically touch, you know, to text you, you don't deserve me to look at you, you're like, I'm getting out of here. Instead of having this attitude, like, how dare you, you know, like, how, you know, like, instead of having the power now, like, seeing that he's in the wrong and having the power for yourself, for herself, instead, what she did, she was like, oh my God, what if he likes the other girl more? What if he realizes that I stalked him? She found him cheating on her. And this is where she would have all the power by walking away and him being like, oh my God, babe, I'm so sorry, running after her, apologizing. Instead of it, she was like, oh my God, what is he gonna think because I stalked him? She gave him more power, not only that he cheated, but she gave him even more power. And ladies, you know, like, if you choose to somebody to give the power away, how will they respect you?
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, like, when you have nothing, nobody will respect you. Nobody respects weak. I actually made a post today.
Men love power.
Men love power, yeah. Power game. It's a power game.
Men,
it's fun.
Literally, why do they go to wars? Why do they, you know, want to be the best at their job and have money and have all the... They want power. They want power and they love a powerful woman. And being a powerful
power
woman
game.
Isn't about... you know, being masculine and like, you know, oh, let me pay for your drinks. Or,
no,
you know, let me I'll open my own car door and carry my own luggage. Like, it's not about that.
No.
It's a totally different thing.
You're feminine, but you have a power. I'm the queen. Okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm the queen. I have my value. I have my worth. I have self-respect. I have the dignity. You know, if you want me, you better step it up. You know, this is your own value, worth, and having the power. Not
absolutely.
Like, oh, I can be as a boy, you know? Like, why would you want to be as a boy? You're blessed to be a girl. Enjoy being feminine. Enjoy being a girl. Okay. Let's see. How can we be same high-value woman in dating, using dating app? Is already look desperate somehow.
No. Everyone's on dating apps. Every single person is on a dating app. Those times have gone where it was like taboo. Like, oh my God, you're on a dating app. You're such a loser. You can't get a date. Now it's like, especially these days in the time of Corona, when you can't meet someone face to face, everyone's on a dating app. It's not embarrassing anymore.
What are you supposed to do?
Exactly.
Like, could you imagine in the time of Corona would be like, I'm such a loser. I'm going out because I'm so desperate to meet a guy.
Exactly.
Dating apps is totally cool. It's totally cool. But to be honest, now it's the time to date outside after Corona stops because everyone is taking dating apps really, really for granted.
Yeah.
Because it's so much choice.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, girls, if you're going to go into a candy shop, there's like millions of sweets, right? Like, you won't know what to pick. And if you kind of choose one and you don't like it or something is off, you're just going to go for another
Paradox of choice is what it's called. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. So this is what dating apps are doing right now. So it's like, you say... you're not feeling it, you know, it doesn't work as well as it used to work.
Yeah,
because we are better when we have less
show dog.
Where is please? Pretty please.
Show dog. Harley's like more popular than both of us right now, right?
Harley, you're taking, because Harley's being a challenge.
Yeah,
she's not in the video. She's being a challenge. Updating WhatsApp DP with no makeup, giving too much update to the guy. Okay, I think we're answering each other's questions.
Okay.
Okay. How? Let me scroll up. Yeah, I'll scroll up. Shams, I think insecurities can be instilled by our partners. Oh, yes. I remember my ex would compare me and put me down. Then I started to get insecure. It's a hard one to deal with, especially he was the first person. Okay. Do you want to go with it?
I think you had a good example, Lonnie. I remember you were talking about, like, you gave a really good example. If a guy puts you down, you know, you gave like an amazing comeback. I remember you said something along, like, if you say, for example, like, you're together and he actually says, oh, babe, that girl on the TV is so hot, you've been putting on a little bit of weight. You can just look, you have to be confident with this, and you have to realize that, like I said before, his opinion isn't that important of you at all. And if he really thought that about you, he wouldn't be sitting on the sofa with you, you know, cuddling you. So that's bullshit. But basically, you turn to him and you put him and make him insecure. You turn to him and say, oh, you know what? I think I look great, but look at this little tummy, tum, tum, squeezy, squeeze, squeeze. You make him insecure.
Give him a taste of his own medicine. Yeah, exactly. Don't be scared. If he is not scared to do this, to put his finger, you know, like, go do back. Do the same thing back.
Exactly.
It's fine. Then he'll be like, oh my God, do you think I should go for a run?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Exactly. Go to the gym as well. Yeah, this picture looks good. I would take it to another level.
Yeah,
oh my God.
Exactly.
Don't give me this opportunity, guys.
Or if like a hot guy, I would maybe save it. And then like the next time I saw him out and then I saw a really hot guy, but oh my God, he's so tall. Look at his eyes. You know, he's so stylish.
Look at your tummy. Yeah, like have a look, you know, like, yeah, I think if you would work here a bit more, you know, like this
look at the way he dresses. You know, maybe you should get that shirt. Like, make him insecure instead. Like, why are you taking it on yourself? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, but I think after that he would kind of
pretty much stop.
Don't be scared, ladies. When you show that you're not scared to stand up for yourself and you actually banter back, this is when he enjoys it too. Because he can't walk all over you.
And men bond through banter.
Yeah, we love banter.
We love the banter.
They love banter. Even, you know, ladies, I'm even reading a book for men. And it's a dating book for men, how to pick up girls. All the coaching guys is banter, fun, banter, fun, banter, fun. So don't take things personally. When we say something off, just don't take it personally. Yeah. You know, because we were either to banter or have fun, or, you know, so many girls ask me like, oh, what do I do? You know, like, we having an argument and he's been so mean and nasty and I'm so upset, I'm crying, because you're taking it personally. Ladies, when you're having arguments with men, and if you actually put yourself in a position that you're actually really arguing and it's getting all nasty, first, you can get out of it. Don't even do it. But second, if you are in this position and you don't know how to behave, at least do not take it personally.
Mm-hmm.
Because he is saying these things not to compromise, not to find a solution, but to win the argument. To win the argument, you know, basically. Yeah, to win the argument. That's what it is. Hi, Ina. Okay, cool. Let's see more. Oh, what is this girl saying?
I think it was something like tips on
this one.
So, someone asked down below.
Okay.
Tips on staying high value path despite being surrounded by low value women.
Ooh.
This is a good one.
Okay, let's read it. Tips on staying on high value path despite being surrounded by low-value women who have been hurt by men, and make it their mission to ruin dating for everyone else by constantly picking men apart.
Yeah, we see this a lot.
Well, ladies, I only met Sandas when I became high-value. And we basically connected when she became high-value.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so when I was changing my... I was obviously not very high-value before, right? And I was changing myself and I invested a lot into personal growth, and then I became high value. But even then, ladies, when you're high value, you don't call yourself high value. Other people call you high value. I'm just kind of giving it as an example. But what did I do when I changed? I let go of the people who I didn't bond anymore with.
Absolutely.
It was very difficult, but you let it go because first you have nothing to talk about. You meet up, you want to talk about business and some things that interest you, and all we want to do is gossip, talk about guys, blame, complain, nag, be negative. I'm like, oh my God, I have nothing to talk about, or watch TV. You know, I'm like, okay, well, I'm focusing on business. I don't really like talking about men in my own spare time. Like, you'll never hear me talking about men ever unless it's my business, you know, and because it's like, it's too much, you know, it's like, that's the last thing I talk about. If you ever want my friend, men will be the last thing on my
mind. I think we hardly talk about men. I think over the last like 4 days, we've not even spoken about them once.
No, now we're speaking about them.
Now we're obviously
because they help.
Yeah, and but we don't sit there and we're like, oh my God, mini crap, they're this, that, and the other. We don't.
Yeah.
I don't sit with women who men bash, and if they do men bash, I change the subject straight away.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to be part of that kind of negative energy. If you can, if you can't get away from them because they're like your mother or your sister or you know your family or they're friends that you've had for a very very long time and they're otherwise okay, then at least change the subject when this subject comes up. If, you know, with some women, they don't want to hear the high value, you know, they don't want to hear it because they're not ready for it.
Yeah.
You have to be ready for the self-development and growth. Otherwise, the majority of women are like, oh, it's the men's fault. I know I'm not doing anything wrong. Even if they're having one failed relationship after another, they're never going to self-look. They're going to look at, he's the problem. No, you're the common denominator. It's you.
Yeah.
It's you. But you're never going to look at and be, you know, humble enough to be even looking at yourself and saying, no, I am the one who needs the work.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
But you need to let people go, ladies. It's very difficult, but it's kind of beyond a choice. Or limit your time with them.
Yeah, absolutely.
Limit your time and, you know, just, you know, if you feel like conversation is turning the way that you need to go home, go home. Oh my God, what time it is? I just realized, go home. Don't get, because you'll feel nasty after. You know, it's not worth it. And a lot of times, another thing, you know, like sometimes we surround ourselves with low value women and we're like, okay, I became high value. Now I feel like I need more friends. But because you already have these girls, you don't have any time for extra friends. So what do? You take one out and you replace it. That's kind of the only way. I sound so mean. Like some, this is like.
To be honest, for me, I have really good friends. Like,
well,
my circle is small. My circle is small, and I have cut people out. Definitely, that I agree with. I've cut people out that I feel like are not on the same page as me anymore. But I have got friends who, when I've shared my ideas about high value, have actually, you know what, they didn't even realize that they had the same passion. So I've actually spoken about it and they've gone, you know what, I agree with you. And I've got my friends who've now come to me and ask me for advice on these things because they know that I know these things. See what I mean? So you have to be, surround yourself with people who are open to at least, you know, sharing your opinion or respecting at the very least. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, I think it's just, it's be careful who you surround yourself with. That's all it is.
Yeah. Life is too precious to surround yourself with losers. Greta and Sundas, could you share what you did to find your passion?
I like that question. That's actually
I know
question.
You like it. I'm thinking maybe, you know what? Maybe we'll do another video for High Value Mindset or something.
Yeah, we should.
Because this is more relationship kind of. So if we'll start, you know. But yeah, we can definitely talk about it because we both have passions.
Absolutely.
Like Sundas is very driven. She's working on her passion and I'm working on mine. This is how we actually connected in a way, in so many ways. Okay, let's go up or down.
Yeah, you have to go all the way up now because there was loads of questions in the beginning that we just didn't see.
My guy said he will call me tonight. He hasn't. Isn't it mean of him for hurting me like this? If he really loved me, he wouldn't try and not hurt me. He is really alpha. Oh,
all the girls,
so sweet.
All the girls say that the guy is alpha. You know how many alpha guys I've met in my life, and I've met a lot of men. It's probably like 0.01%.
I know my dad was alpha. Is alpha.
My dad was alpha.
But the other ones
rare.
Compared to my dad, is nothing.
In England, you know how many alpha men I've met. I'm dying to meet an alpha guy. Like, ladies, I love it when you're like, my guy is alpha. And I'm like, I guarantee you he's not. He's just a typical guy. An alpha guy, majority of women, you wouldn't handle him for 1 month. You wouldn't be able, you couldn't keep him around even for 1 month. Unless you switch to high value and you are nailing it.
If you're nailing at high value, you will. Anyway, don't worry. Okay, he's alpha. We give you that. We'll answer your question.
Yeah.
So, what do you do? How do you behave if he says he's gonna call you and he doesn't? So let's talk about how you I'll tell you how you should not behave, and Sandas will tell you how you should behave.
Okay.
Yeah, that's more fun. Okay. Yeah, okay. So how you should not behave. When he tells you, I'm gonna call you tonight, and he doesn't call you, you don't call him complaining. You don't call him saying, oh my God, I've been waiting for your phone call all day. I feel hurt. I feel like you don't love me. Are you talking to someone else? Did you forget about me? Calling him, texting him instead. This is how you do not behave, because that's very, very insecure. And you're kind of showing that you've been waiting for his phone call all day long. And he's the only thing that's on your mind. So you're giving him a lot of safety and security. That's not his love need. His love need is uncertainty. So Sandas, how do we give him uncertainty back?
We go about our day. And we do the things that we would normally do, that we weren't even worried about whether he's not going to phone us or not. We're not checking our phone. I'm like, literally, I'm doing my work. I'm talking to my friends. I'm getting on with the things that I need to be doing. And I've completely forgotten that he was going to call me or not, because I'm so busy doing my own thing.
Yeah.
And then when he finally says, oh, sorry, I didn't call you, I'm like, oh, were we supposed to be on? Oh, sorry. I forgot myself.
I've been so busy.
Yeah, I completely forgot myself.
No worries.
Exactly.
Fine. Who's gonna get insecure when, ladies? Mm-hmm. This is how you actually
Absolutely. He
digs you a trap. And he falls himself into his own trap. He'll be like, how did she forgot?
There's a really good question I just saw, and the girl's asking, Jeannie is asking, beautiful souls, hi, as a high value woman, you attract all sorts of men. Yes, this is true. You cannot stop who's going to approach you, but how do you choose the right one? This is a good question.
How do you choose the right guy?
Because I see a lot of women who are practicing high value are staying with losers.
Oh, yes. But you know what? Because we see high value as a game.
Mm-hmm.
Girls who come to this channel first, a lot of you girls, like, I don't mean to, you know, like, you date guys who are not very
high value.
High value. I'm trying to be nice, you know. But yeah, you date guys who are not very high value. And then you start applying these tips, right? And then you still stay with these guys. But I kind of lost my point, actually.
But when you upgrade yourself, when you start
when you upgrade yourself, basically, when you start to love yourself and you upgrade yourself, this is when that guy is going to be not good enough for you.
You're going to question it
yourself. Yeah, you're going to question it. But I had another point as well. But anyway.
But if men are approaching you, if men are approaching you, absolutely, you cannot control who's going to approach you or not. High value is a filter. Mm. You're going to basically have boundaries. You're going to have standards. And if he's not going to meet those standards and those boundaries, you're not going to respect those boundaries, that man is either going to naturally drop off, or you're not going to give him enough
high
time
value
anyway.
High value woman does not date low value man.
Exactly.
Because he does not pass her tests. We have tests. Do you test, man? I bloody test them.
Absolutely.
I always test, man. I always tested them, no matter it was high value, low value. And I only dated cool dudes because I bloody test them to the core.
Absolutely.
You know?
So that's how you check if a guy's good enough for you. You set your standard, you have your boundaries, you follow Greta's advice. And if he's not matching, he's going to either fall off himself or you get rid of him. Don't waste your time with him. Stop
he's
replying.
He's going to drop off.
Exactly.
Or he's going to be chasing and pursuing and you're like, and acting all needy. And you're going to be, well, you know, like you don't have your goals, you don't have your dreams. Mm-hmm. You're telling me to chase you. You're asking me why you haven't,
Get rid of him. Exactly.
Yeah. So Yeah, so what was the question? How to find high value man? Or
How to decide which one is right for you.
Oh.
So, and after you've gotten
have
rid
your
of
standards.
All of the, yeah, after those guys have fallen off, the very few cream of the crop will rise to the top. And those are the men that you can then be like, okay.
You only need one guy,
exactly,
ladies.
Exactly, of 6 billion people on the planet.
Yeah, exactly. And believe, and don't settle for less.
Absolutely.
Patience get rewarded.
Absolutely.
Patience. Let me, you know what, ladies? Yeah, okay. I'll for next time, this topic. Okay, which one was good question? Did you see something?
That was the one I saw that we just did.
Okay.
So you can go ahead and pick whichever one.
Okay, let's see. Right, drama queen. Greta, do you think all hope is lost for relationships in the younger generation who is very liberal and progressive and beginning to treat the changing gender roles as a new social norm?
That's
oh my
a
God.
Really good question. Because we're moving,
well, this
yeah.
this is why we have women like us, right? To influence people that there are rules that we need to follow in order to live a happy life.
Absolutely.
If everybody were following the rules, you wouldn't need me and Sundas.
Yeah.
You know, but people are not following the rules. They are losing themselves. They wearing their heart on a sleeve. They doing whatever we want to do. They like, we go like, oh my God, I'm a rule breaker.
Yeah.
Then they get totally messed up in the head. They don't understand what is wrong with them. Like, you know, for example, ladies sleeping around like crazy, mm-hmm. Copying men, acting like a man, and then thinking, why am I so like, why
bitter,
am I not happy,
and,
why
yeah.
I'm bitter, why I'm blaming and complaining, why, you know, why? Because you're not following the rules of God or universe or whichever rules, you're just not following the rules.
Yeah.
And when you don't follow the rules are created so your life is better.
Yeah.
You know, rules are not making your life worse. Like, look at it, like kids example, right? If you're raising a child and you let a child do whatever he wants, your child will grow up a spoiled brat. He mm-hmm. will abuse his mom. He will abuse his dad. He will spit on his sister and do whatever as he pleases. Whenever he doesn't get his sweetie, he's going to throw you the biggest tantrum. You're going to be so embarrassed. And if you actually reward him with the sweetie after, because you're like, oh my God, stop screaming, here is the sweetie. You're actually rewarding a bad attention. And, you know, this is what happens when you... when you don't set in any rules, when you let somebody not follow the rules,
yeah.
or when you don't follow them yourself.
Absolutely.
So same as, you know, you're in charge of your child, so it needs to follow the rules to grow up a healthy, good boy or girl, right? Same when you grow up, right? Now you're mature, over 18, you are in charge of your life. You know, like your parents are like, okay, you're independent now. Now you need to think, okay, in life, what rules do I need to follow to live a happy life?
Yeah, absolutely.
Not like, what rules do I need to break? Oh my God, I'm 18, freedom, let's break rules,
yeah,
you know?
Exactly. But I don't feel like all hope is lost. I
no,
think that as long
not.
As you kind of, you know, try and work
yeah.
on yourself and spread the message.
Yeah.
And try and get other ladies on board and teach your daughters and your sons to follow, like, the proper... you know, a man has love needs, a woman has love needs, and what they are, then you're not going to have this problem in the coming generation. So I think it's on us and our responsibility to make sure that this message is getting passed on and the coming generations actually do stand a chance
yeah.
of having help, you know, healthy, happy relationships where, you know, they're not bitter towards each other. We're not changing a guy and a woman every night, every 3 hours. Some guys will go through a woman, like three women in a day. Like, it's ridiculous. And they won't even know their names.
Yeah.
They'll just name, label them as girl number one who's an artist, girl number two who works as an accountant. Like, this is how they label these women. Do you know what I mean? And it's...
I had a guy sharing with me. I actually heard him talking to his brother. And the guy treated me like incredible, like a sister. Like, he respected me so much. I heard him calling his brother and competing, right, with his brother. We were both crazy hot. Competing with his brother, saying, how many times did you had sex with that girl? And him sharing how many times he done it too. and who won the game.
Yeah, this is how they treat these women.
Yeah,
don't be that girl.
And I have goosebumps because it's a true story.
Yeah,
and I like remember listening to them and thinking like, oh my god, poor girls, I can't believe how well you are treating me and how much respect and love and care you're giving me. And who's not, wasn't my boyfriend or anything, he was like a friend, right? And how you are treating these girls who you just pick up at night and call your brother to bloody, you have a competition.
Yeah, or you just say, I can't be bothered to drop you off, yeah. So just grab an Uber and go home, because they don't even give you that much respect.
No, yeah.
To send, you know, to actually make sure you get home
safely.
They'll
do that and leave you in a bush, ladies. Done.
Oh my god.
Why should I care about her?
Yeah, exactly. This, he got what he wanted.
Like, be wise. Be wise.
Put a value on yourself. That's
higher than
just
being...
Yeah,
if you don't value yourself, no one else will.
Exactly.
Have your boundaries. Don't be gullible. Be there to charm you.
Yeah.
You know, we read these books, be like, what am I going to do? What should I say to her?
Mm-hmm.
So she is like, oh, yeah, you are like, you know, happy family.
Yeah, he wants to marry me after two
I'm
dates.
I'm the princess.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I'm the he thinks I'm the most beautiful girl.
Yeah. So I should do everything he wants me to.
So I don't lose him.
Yes.
It's Prince Charming.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Jump on one foot and change my hair color.
Cook for me.
Yeah.
Do my laundry.
I don't understand who could possibly be caring about the man's attention at them like this.
Time like this, yeah. I don't know.
Corona. Yeah.
There's women who are worried about it. There's loads of women.
Yeah.
Who are like, oh my god, I can't meet up with him. Can I just go to his house? No.
Yeah. What is this question? Is that before being understood to this type of, is it important that you know what a best friend looks like? I'm not understanding, sorry.
No,
what is this? Why do some women end up with needy men? Some women end up with distant and emotionally unavailable men. What are we doing differently? Are these both low-value men? I don't really believe in emotionally unavailable men. If he, like, yes, guys will be emotionally unavailable, same as you can be, like, for example, you're getting over an ex and so on. However, if you think about it, right, you broke up with the guy or he broke up with you and you're getting over him. If you will meet a guy that is better than your ex, you will forget your ex. You will be like, oh my god, I'm so blessed, thank you for dumping me so much, you know, like I'm actually very somebody better. So with emotionally unavailable guys, the same thing. If even if he's heartbroken, even if things has happened, if he will meet the girl who is better than an ex, he'll get all emotionally available.
Yeah.
And
real
I've seen
quick.
It happening, yeah. And I've seen it happening so many times.
Is this an excuse they make?
It's an excuse. What was the first question? I forgot.
Needy men.
Needy
Are these
men.
Women
oh.
doing something differently?
With needy guys, ladies, with needy guys, basically a lot of like attracts like. If you're a needy woman, you will probably want a needy man.
Mm-hmm.
I know one lady, she's incredible, very ambitious, very successful and so on, but she's very insecure, doesn't love herself, and she's very, very needy. And her boyfriend, she met a guy who basically is doing everything for her, like literally gave away his life for her, doing everything for her, but he is crazy needy, crazy controlling, like checking her every single move. Now she's like suffocated, like she cannot breathe, you know. So ladies, it's another way of danger. If a man is like really low value and he's like, all of you want a man to do everything for you, that's not the right way to think. If he starts to give away his life for you and does everything for you, he's damaging himself.
Yeah.
You know, and you're gonna get suffocated as well, because the whole life will be just about you.
Yeah.
He's not gonna grow. He's not gonna improve. Where are his goals? Where are his dreams? If it's all about you, you know, you're gonna get suffocated. He's gonna put his happiness on you, rely on you, and nobody's gonna be happy. So ladies, you know, like if a man has dreams, goals, if even if he's giving you a bit of uncertainty, if he's not that available, be happy, let him have his goals and dreams, support him in the goals and dreams, give him that space that he needs. We are here not just to be dependent on each other. Oh my God, I found a husband, now I'm gonna hold on and like, you know, stuck to him like this, you know, and we just gonna walk like this. No, you're here to make a difference, to create an incredible life for yourself, you know, to leave a legacy, to change the world, to there's a million things that you can do for you and for him. You both need to live like incredible, healthy, happy lives.
A masculine man wouldn't do that. That's not true. There are some extremely masculine men who are incredibly needy.
Yeah.
Because they are insecure.
They don't love themselves. Yes. They don't know how, they have not been raised in a way.
And you will be shocked. Like some of these guys, I've met these guys who are like really good looking, have a great job, everything going for him. But he's like a woman is insecure. He's very insecure. And because of that, he needs constant
reassurance
from you. Absolutely. That, am I good enough? Where are you? Are you cheating on me?
Yeah.
This, that, and the other. Who are you talking to? Yeah. Who are you with? La, la. He's going to constantly need that from you because he's very insecure. So it's not about masculine, not masculine. It's about, like Greta said, self-love, confidence, working on your own self-belief and security. And if you're not going to have that in yourself, you're always going to look for it in somebody else. And
this is why you ladies need to be wise when you're choosing a guy.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, like, see, is it just all about you and he's like obsessed with you and he dropped everything for you, you know, or does he still have his goals, his dreams? You know, like, you don't need to take over his life, same as you, like, he doesn't need to take over your life. I think let's maybe do one more question and then it's already 50 minutes, which is awesome. Ladies, let us know after this video in the comments, like, how you finding this life, because we kind of stuck together in the quarantine, so we could do this quite, you know, regularly until I move to the place where...
Down the street, probably.
Down the street. Okay, so, let's see... She's telling needy man is a nightmare. Needy man is a nightmare.
Yeah, I don't like needy man either.
Prince Harry is super needy. I don't know. I never met him.
Yeah, we don't know about him either. I don't know about him either.
I never met him. How to behave if my boyfriend refuses to let other girls know that he is taken? Together since 1 year, but no relationship status, no pictures together, but he is very active on social media. Oh. So, if he refuses to tell everyone that he's taken, it's because he does not see you as a serious relationship.
Long-term thing.
He does not see you as long-term. If he would see, if he would love you and see you as long-term, he would be showing you off to everyone.
Yes.
He would be like, this is my love.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? And be like, oh, you know, my
so
love.
So nobody else can take you.
Yes.
He wants everybody to know.
I love my, you know, everything. You know, this is how a man behaves when he loves you and he wants a relationship with you and he sees you as a, you know, a serious, something serious, right?
Yeah.
When he see, when he doesn't see that, but he, you know, has his cake, eats it too, he's kind of unsure about you, this is when he'll be hiding you, you know, and keeping an eye open.
Absolutely.
But it's because, most of the time, it is because you are not nailing at being high value. You're either giving him too much safety and security, maybe you're too focused on him, maybe you don't have your goals, your dreams, maybe you're not into personal development,
maybe you're insecure.
Maybe you're insecure, maybe you're not controlling your emotions.
Or jealous. There's many millions of things you could be doing wrong. But the only way to find out is if you're kind of, you know, you're getting the help, and this is what we're here for.
Yeah,
you know,
you need the help. Come to us, ladies. VIP 1, VIP 2, me, Sandas, and another girl, Joanna. We will be coaching you in a group setting 3 times a week, live streams, answering
Absolutely.
Your questions. We'll put
and these
all
situations
the
are fixable. Sorry, go on.
No,
Greg's going to put all the details.
I'll put all the details in the video description. Like, if you want to join VIP 1 or VIP
Absolutely.
2, where Sandas and me are coaching, and Joanna as well, but Juana is in Canada, so we
couldn't bring her.
You know? So
Juana, well, she's awesome, and she's exactly the same stuff we're saying is what she would say to you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, exactly.
But all of these situations are fixable, and they can be turned around, and a man can go from seeing you as not long-term wife material to, you know, seeing you as no, he can't live without
you.
That's
our job.
Exactly.
That's our job to turn it around. Absolutely. That he doesn't see you as a girlfriend material, and he's hiding you. Our job is so he sees you as a serious 100%. Girlfriend material, but we're not changing the guy. We are changing you.
Yeah.
Okay, so no man blaming. Taking responsibility for yourself.
Yeah.
Learning how to love, value yourself, set in boundaries that the guy was breaking them.
Exactly.
And
exactly.
So on. So thank you so much, ladies, for watching. You for taking part in my awesome live.
Yeah, it's been great.
Yeah, you loved it?
Yeah, I did. Good. Very much enjoyed it. It's been great to talk to all you ladies, and
yeah, it's really cool.
Stay safe.
Stay safe. Don't go out of your way for Corona. Join the VIP 1 or 2. I will put the links in this video description. And ladies, oh gosh, I forgot. I lose sometimes, like, Sandas knows it. Like, have a thought. I'm like, Sandas.
It's not Corona. Don't worry. She doesn't have Corona, God forbid.
I don't have Corona. I do, like, we watching something. I'm like, yeah. Oh my God, I got it. And she's, like, listening. And I'm like, I forgot. Yeah, okay, ladies. So, kisses. Have a beautiful... Yeah. Oh, yes, I remembered. So, this is what it is. Let us know after this live in the comments below, did you enjoyed me and Sandas being together? Okay? I would love to see the comments. Okay? So
absolutely.
Have a beautiful day. Kisses from
Manchester.
Yes, Manchester. Bye, ladies.